Guys, this is Giridhar from Mobigan. Today we are at New York, the launch event of Nokia Lumia 1020. So here we have the Nokia Lumia 1020 with us. So this one has got a 41 megapixel camera, which is not surprising because there have been many leaks and rumors about the camera and the design and specifications, but most of them have turned out to be true, which is a good thing, because I believe that whatever were the rumors and whatever the speculations were there earlier, if they come true, I would be happy. So this device made me say wow, and it's got a wow factor, mainly because of its design language and the camera at the back. So the design, it's directly inherited from the Nokia Lumia series. So from if you look at the device on the front, you would see that it resembles a N920 or even a 925. So not the 925, but just the 920. But at the back, you would see a slight hunch to accommodate the 41 megapixel camera. But this hunch is much less prominent than the one we saw in the Nokia PureView 808. And speaking about the camera, it's got a 41 megapixel and the lens is 6 element glass, and only the first element is a glass, the rest of the plastic lenses. We have all these lenses stacked on top of each other, but they are also supported by an optical image stabilization. All these lenses sit on a coil and assisted by a gyroscope, so they give a better stabilization. Even the DSLRs stabilize just one lens at the front, but this particular lens stabilizes all 6 lenses for better imaging quality. The xenon flash is helpful for taking bright images, while the LED is assisting the video capture. And speaking of the hardware design, on this side you would see the volume rocker, the power on button, which also serves as the lock unlock button, and the dedicated camera shutter key. At the bottom you have the speaker grill, the USB micro USB slot, which also serves as a charging point, plus a data transfer. On the left side, it's practically blank, there's nothing in it. And at the top, you see you have the 3.5mm audio jack along with the micro SIM slot. And at the back, you have the 41 megapixel camera, and also there are two small slots here, to which the charging plate kind of snaps on. So in a moment I'll also show you that. And speaking of the camera, so clicking the camera button starts the camera application for you. The camera application, there is also an interesting camera application announced by Nokia today. So it's a third party application called the Nokia Pro Cam. So this can be set to be the default camera application for you. So in this device it's been set like that. So the default application which you see here is the Nokia Pro Cam. So the Nokia Pro Cam has got the ability to tweak a lot of settings while shooting an image. So here you see the ability to change the white balance, and to switch from auto to manual focus, and to change the ISO settings here, and the ISO ranges from 100 to 3200 here. And also you have the shutter speed changing capability. The shutter speed, the longest shutter speed you can have is 4 seconds, while the shortest is 1 by 16,000. And also you can change the You can change the white balance here, and if you want to reset everything to the default, you can just swipe the icon across. So once I've taken an image, let me zoom in and take a picture here. And this image, I can unzoom it. So I just click on this icon here, which brings this image back to me. And I can unzoom it. I can see the entire frame again, and I can recompose it and say save. So maybe this is what Nokia called reinventing the zoom. This is a great feature for photographers, and me being interested in photography, I think that this device is going to enhance the photographing experience of an user. So would I buy it? Yes, I would definitely buy it, even though I am a little skeptic about getting into the Windows ecosphere, but still I would buy this device as an accessory and as a secondary camera for me, because right now I have the HTC One X with me, and I feel there is a lot of limitations with the camera in it. Especially after seeing this, I feel all my limitations have been opened up. So I am going to buy this. Okay. So that's it about the camera, and we have a couple of exciting accessories launched along with this. So this one is the camera grip. The camera grip also has a 1020 mAh external battery to it, and it also has a dedicated shutter button, which is a two-step shutter. The first step, it actually zooms the image, and on the second step, it clicks the image. And we have the tripod mount here at the bottom, which is a standard tripod mount, which can fit into any of your tripods used by a professional DSLR or even a amateur point-and-shoot cameras. And this is made of a polycarbonate material, the same material which is used in this unibody design of the Nokia Lumia 1020. And the other accessory that was announced today was the charging plate. So Nokia Lumia 1020 doesn't have wireless charging inbuilt, but you can add the capability by just snapping on this grip onto it. So once I've snapped it on, I can do a wireless charging to this. So these are two accessories that's been launched today, apart from the SDK, new SDK, and also augmented reality in the maps, here maps. So it's available in yellow, white, and black. And it's going to be first available in the US with the AT&T, and if you're going for a two-year contract, you can get it for $299.99. While you can get this camera grip for $79. I'm not sure about the pricing of the charging plate. Do you have any idea of charging plate?
It would be about 29 euros, but not sure what the USD price is, but I can find it out.
Okay, so we are not really clear about the pricing of the charging plate. So that's it from my end. So we are looking forward to actually have an hands-on on this device and do an in-depth review. So stay tuned to Movingan. Thanks for watching the video.